Hello and welcome back to another video on Dbt. And one of the coolest things about an open source project is the fact that there's a ton of different developers and they may be doing things that you are working on that you want to add to your project as well. The way that Dbt handles that is through packages. So what is a package? At the end of the day, a package is a standalone Dbt project with their own models and macros within it. And as a user who is downloading their package, you then have access to all of those as well. So how do you add these to your project locally? The first step is you have to add a packages.yml file to your project. This should be on the same level as a dbt project file. This doesn't come by default in the dbt init process, and it's something you'll have to add on your own. So if we go back to our project, here's that same level, here's that dbt project. I'm going to add a new file, paste in that name. Now that we have this, we can add any packages that we want to this file. How do we do that? What I'd like to show you is Dbt Hub, which is the communal place to find a lot of these packages that other people are sharing. And you can see this is the community location for all these packages. And here's a very simple one that is really useful, one of the basic ones, Dbt Utils. Obviously, you could search around here and find all sorts of stuff. For this example, we'll try this one. And as it says, this is all you have to do to install this is include it in your packages.yml file. So let's copy this. You can see it starts with packages, has the name and the version. Now that we have this in here, the command that we need to run is dbt deps, and that will install the package. It will not only install this one, but if you had multiple ones in here, it would go through and install all of them as well. So dbt deps, it will look into your packages.yml file and recognize if it exists on the hub. And if it does, it'll grab all of the folders and files and download it for you based on the specific version. So here we go. We can see it installed and we're all set. And if you wanted to see where these files are actually stored on your project, it's this dbt modules folder here. And we can see dbt utils is now here. And you can see all of the specific macros, all of the underlying queries and logic that goes into anything that you would use here. So again, open source, completely transparent in terms of what you're getting, and you can now use these however you want. And hopefully save yourself some time as you work with Dbt to build out your project and build out your data warehouse. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment, and I'll see you at the next video. Thanks for watching.